Hi, my name is Shomik Sakib. I am a graduate research assistant here in University of Kansas Civil Engineering Department, and our lab is all about transportation engineering. It's called the Driving Simulator Lab. Vehicle automation constitutes a new era in transportation as it promises increased level of safety and capacity. The automotive industry has developed technology such as adaptive cruise control and automatic lane following that can control the vehicle's speed and trajectory. However, it is not entirely known how these new systems will affect drivers' behavior, like reaction time or cognitive load, or how drivers will adapt to these new technologies. As such, the purpose of this project is to investigate driver workload and situation awareness changes during partial vehicle automation levels, and specifically when drivers will switch from automated mode to manual driving mode. To accomplish our goal, we are using KU Driving Simulator to simulate different traffic scenarios and traffic conditions under which drivers will be observed to change the vehicle control from automated to manual, adapt their behavior, and we will measure behavior and their driving performances. Our goal is to develop a micro-simulation tool that can be used by transportation researchers and professionals to better describe and predict traffic phenomena due to the interactions between the various vehicles and drivers and due to behavioral adaptations. Our effort will also help in estimating more accurate values of freeway capacity once these automated vehicles penetrate the existing fleet in increasing numbers.
Okay. Hello, my name is Grace Savoy and I'm currently a third year undergrad civil engineering student. What our lab is doing is important because we will be taking our analyses from interactions between various vehicles and drivers and create micro-simulation tools that will help transportation researchers and professionals better describe and understand the flow of traffic.
With the use of advanced measurement tools and techniques, we are able to measure these parameters. For example, our cameras and eye tracking sensors inside the cab will provide the instantaneous behavioral information of the drivers while they face different scenarios and workloads. We can explore drivers by analyzing the pupil diameter, movement of the eye, fixation, and reaction time. As we transition to partially automated or fully automated driving systems, the development of realistic driving behavior models and traffic engineering tools that incorporate behavioral adaptation is crucial.